A TSBVI Outreach Tutorial. APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics, aka Graph Board. Part 2, Plotting Points, and Creating Geometric Figures on the Coordinate Plane. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
All right, we're now going to go ahead and graph a few simple points. But first, we want to create the coordinate plane by using two rubber bands, or actually several rubber bands together, knotted together. And actually, when I was doing this one time, I had someone say, please stop and show me that. So again, I have my little bag here, and this contains several of the colored push pins. So I'm going to have those. And then this little box should have my thumbtacks. So I'm going to have to get a few thumbtacks. And then these are actually my rubber bands. And I'm just going to decide that we're going to take three rubber bands. And bottom line, I'll just try to show you how I do this. Some of you are going, oh, I can do that. Okay, so I've got two together. And then we're going to go ahead and do that again. Maybe I can't do it. I knew this was going to happen. Here we go. Okay. It's very simple when I'm off camera. Okay. So bottom line, in this particular case, I've strung three rubber bands together. One of the things we want to be sure of is not to let it pop. Then I'm going to put a thumbtack. And I'm not sitting here counting, is that 15 over exactly? And it doesn't matter. In fact, you probably will want to change this up some, or you're going to have the same holes being used over and over again. So we're going to do the y-axis first, and we just put the rubber band over the tip of the thumbtack. These thumbtacks are pretty huge, more for the camera than anything else. You don't have to use this large of a thumbtack. But bottom line, that holds your y-axis down pretty well, and it's still okay with the three rubber bands that it's not stretched and ready to pop. You will have students that want to pop rubber bands and send push pins flying. I tell students that this is a privilege to use this board, and if they want to play with it, they may lose the privilege, and then it's amazing. So they like it so much that they actually concentrate on doing their mathematics. Again, I'm not going to count exactly, but I'm going to put it about halfway. And the thing that you need to be very careful of is that you're lining up your thumbtacks so that they are, when you put your rubber band on, this is going to be semi-straight there across. So let's see, maybe I didn't even need three rubber bands for the x-axis, but let's see. You do want that to be quite taut. Okay. And then, initially I used to just leave it like this, but I had a lot of students who really felt that they needed a placement for the origin or 0, 0 or where the two axes cross. So if your student needs it, you can put another thumbtack right there at the origin. Now if they end up plotting something that has to go right there, you may have to replace that thumbtack with a push pin, and I'll show you what I'm speaking about. Now I'm going to see if I can't go ahead and plot a few points, keeping in mind that I'm going to be upside down here a little bit, so let's see if I can do this. If you start at the origin and you're going to plot a point, and the point happens to be 2, 3, you are going to go to your right, 2, and up, 3, and go ahead and put your push pin in. I'm not going to say that that's the exact technique the students use, especially since they're not doing it upside down here like I am. If you want to graph the point negative 2, 3, you would go to the left 2 and up 3, and then plot your point. And by the way, sometimes students just say, oh, I want all blue and white, Miss O, or I all want this and that color. Because a lot of the time, your Braille student will actually have the ability to see certain colors. And if they can see that color, by all means, get them these colorful push pins. Okay, I'm very carefully picking my points right now. So I'm going to pick now a point that's 2, negative 3. So it's going to go to the right 2 and down 3 and place another point, another push pin. And then my last point for right now will be negative 2, 1, 2, negative 3, 1, 2, 3. I have to look at this later and make sure I said that all perfectly correctly. And then I usually, we plot those points, and then I might ask them to connect all their points. and tell me what kind of a figure they have. And we might even talk about how these two points are symmetric with regard to the y-axis, because this is 2 over this way and this is 2 that way. We have got symmetry across the y-axis, same down here. Then we can look at symmetry across the x-axis. It's 1, 2, 3 to get to the x-axis, or 1, 2, 3 to get to the x-axis. Anyway, lots of things that you can do. But bottom line, this is how you, if you needed to know how to plot points on the coordinate plane, first you've got to create your x and y-axis. And also, you could teach them about quadrants. This is quadrant 1, 2, 3, 4. And I have my students step do that. I'll say, okay, quadrant 1, 2, 3, 4, real quick, and they'll go. And they have a lot of fun with that. You can spend all kinds of time and fun just plotting these points and figuring out which quadrant they're in and so forth. And again, it's visual and it's also tactile. And depending on what you have, you don't have to have this greatest new graphic aid for mathematics or graph board. You can have one of the older ones as well. But anyway, this is how you would do it on the graph board, plotting points and then perhaps making a figure. You might have them plot other points. Sometimes we'll do that type of thing, and they may make it bigger so the rubber bands will stretch a little bit. You may want to have them make a triangle. We'll get another rubber band for that. Oops, I'm getting all these too small or too big. And sometimes I actually have them rest them kind of down underneath this little portion of the push pin so that it really lies good and flat. But anyway, this lesson is basically just showing you how to graph on the coordinate plane, just plotting points and perhaps connecting the dots to make a particular figure. And students will spend hours having fun, not even realizing that they are actually doing math when they get to do this type of thing. Okay, so that's plotting points on the coordinate plane.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Programs. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756 USA. Telephone 512-454-8631. Website www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009. All rights reserved.